shame, cause what is it now, all for one and one for all? The time is now, all your friends, we are called to get involved. Register with the National Identification Authority, a nation, cause what is it now, all for one and one for all?
That was 2008. When Ghanaians were called upon to register for a national identity card. Nearly a decade afterwards, the country has not been able to successfully issue its citizens, both home and abroad, with ID cards.
Because all of these transactions preceded the national identification, people have been doing business without it. Now the law has been passed by Parliament of Ghana, and it is a requirement. All these institutions are to demand the Ghana card before they offer services, not to only foreign nationals, but to Ghanaian citizens. It was because that, as I said, we've not completed issuing ID cards to everybody. That's why the enforcement has not started, but we're starting it now.
A report by the Committee on Communications of Parliament, released in May 2017, showed that the National Identification Authority is yet to register and issue a national identity card to 83% of the country's estimated 27 million people. The report also revealed that only 4.5 million resident Ghanaians have national IDs.
Ghana has been struggling to provide its citizens with a national identity card since 1973. The most recent attempt was in 2014, but that also suffered major setbacks with logistics and funding. Once again, the National Identification Authority will be making a bold attempt. This time it says the process of issuing the identity card will be made instant. Could this be the solution to the challenges the country has faced over the years?
Executive Secretary of the National Identification Authority, Professor Ken Atefua, having held the same position in 2008 under the Eswal John Kufuor administration, says the public-private partnership in rolling out the new ID cards will overcome the challenges experienced in the past.
Those who have the old cards, their old cards remain valid until they themselves have registered and been issued with a new one. The moment your new card is activated, your old card is deactivated. It is killed. So that's number one. So as I indicated, we'll be rolling out from Accra. By the time we get to Upper East, for example, most Ghanaians outside the Upper East would have received their ID cards. But those still in Upper East would be able to use their old card until the day each of them as individuals receives the new Ghana card.
Despite these explanations given by the National Identification Authority on the need for new ID cards, a section of the public want a thorough execution of the registration process.
Even with the first one we did, we went through a lot of problems, forming queues and those things. So for me, when they are going to do a new one, I don't think, for me, I will not go and do it. For me, I will not go and do it. Because I have the old one already. But if they are going to get rid of the old one and go with the new one, for that one I'll apply for it.
Say kokoye na se obia benya ne de enye te se first na obia san kan de bi mu gya bi mu anya ebi mu so ho a edin no oye be ma o se na mu be ya no o me ye no ba din ene gu card no so entinu so obia benya ne de na enko ye se bi de be kam de a ene ye.
I think it's time wasting and waste of money as well, because I don't know what's wrong with the old ones. For you to change something, you have to give us a reason why you are changing, because the old ones are okay, we are using it. And you are saying we should change it to a new one. So it means another whole lot of process people go through to get a new one. It's a whole lot of things. So it means that the old ones are not going to be valid. They want to use the new ones, and it's a problem, really.
According to Executive Chairman of Margins Group, the private firm that manufactures the ID cards, Moses Baden, the new cards have a lot of security features that will make it difficult to produce fake ones.
We are together with NIA, with lessons learned since 2007, developed a very good healthy relationship where we exchange in public sector, private sector ideas in order to arrive at a platform that we are very confident can deliver the project. We hope that we get the support of all of you and bring out this positive news. We believe that this national ID card in the format that is in now will be the key that leapfrogs us from the old world into the new digital world.
the National Identification Project is expected to be completed within 1 year in fulfillment of the manifesto pledge of the NPP government.
From where I sit, and knowing the commitments of the government's commitment to ensuring the success of this project, I have no doubt that government will put its money where its mouth is and support this National Identification System project. I believe government recognizes more than anyone else the centrality of this identification system to the progress, to the development of this country. I think we are united as a people this time round, unlike times past, that this is crucial to the peace, development, and social harmony of this country. It is imperative that we succeed. And I believe that government will give the NIA and the NIS system all the support that is warranted in order to ensure success.
The National Identification Authority is convinced that the new national ID cards would help formalize the economy through the establishment of a national database with linkages to the databases of institutions such as the police, National Health Insurance Scheme, Passport Office, DVLA, Immigration and Ghana Revenue Authority.